You know, I used to think I didn't like racing games. But what I realised years later was that I did like racing games, just not realistic ones. You know, the ones where you have to worry about your tuning and changing parts and handling versus speed or whatever. Like your Forzas, your Gran Turismos. I don't find cars interesting anyway, so that's probably a big contributor. And it's hard to get excited when the game is shoving car name brands in my face that I'm supposed to get excited about, when really all a nice car does is make your celebrity death crash photos more interesting to look at. I'm not bothered about having a nice car, but if my decapitated coked up head is either lying on the bonnet of a Bugatti or a Nissan Micra, I guess I'd choose the Bugatti. So I'm arcade mechanics all the way, and Mashed fits that bill pretty well. At least it was called Mashed over here. In the US, the original version of the game was just called Drive to Survive, but over here it was called Mashed Drive to Survive, and came out in 2004. But then in 2005, they released Mashed Fully Loaded, which was basically just an updated version of Drive to Survive as far as I can tell, which was the version that I first played and is the version that I've got here. The bottom line is that this game was the tits back in the day. At least for me. I never owned a GameCube or an N64, but what I did have was a PS2 with this on it, and this might as well have been my smash. The amount of hours I've probably collectively sank into this game in couch multiplayer is ridiculous, but for how many hours I've theoretically put into it, Mashed is a pretty unknown game. In general, I think I've only ever spoken to one other person that played Mashed outside of the group that I played it with back on the PS2. I could be wrong, and maybe more people played it, but not that I've ever met them. Fully Loaded did have a PC port, but at the time of writing, I can't find a copy anywhere. So yes, this is a PS2 emulator running a version that I would have played back in the day. I own Mashed Drive to Survive on Steam, but bizarrely you can't get Fully Loaded anywhere, which is a shame since Fully Loaded is the optimal way to play the game. So how is it? Well, Mashed is a game that pretty much tells you everything you could ever want to know about it in its opening cutscene. It has cars, some of those cars have guns on them, and the AI is going to use those guns to do bad things to you. There is no story to Mashed at all, and to be honest, why would there? It's gameplay first. Though that doesn't mean I haven't created my own headcanon. From what I can tell, Mashed takes place in the near future, where some upstart company that is funded by makers and publishers of the game, apparently, buys some surplus military hardware from Eastern Europe and starts their own death race. Obviously, based on the maps, these aren't done legally, and are typically done in secret, with seats being sold only to the rich and connected. The clientele would have to be pretty fucked too, since it's basically a vehicular snuff show. Nothing is televised from the looks of things, so I can only assume this is one of those one and done things. I can only guess that the drivers in these races are either racing for substantial prize money, or are imprisoned and racing for their freedom. With that out of the way, on a basic level, Mashed is a car combat game where the aim is to either outrace or outgun other races. There's three challenge cups consisting of bronze, silver, and gold, and some of the maps have ice and night variants. This makes up the whole of the game's campaign mode, essentially. Once you beat the main campaign with all cups, you unlock some bonus maps and the night, ice, and turbo challenge cups, though these are really just little bonuses that don't add that much to the experience. In each of these races, you take on the AI in different game modes to progress through the tournament and earn cups. So far, pretty basic and pretty standard racing game stuff. The game's main game mode is called Battle, and it's what you're primarily going to be playing for the majority of the game. In Battle, the aim is to survive the round. You can do this by taking out other opponents using weapons, ramming them into obstacles, or accelerating ahead and off the screen. Anyone left behind will explode once you leave the screen. The round ends, and the game awards scores based on a scoring system that, to be honest, I'm not entirely sure I understand. Lose enough rounds, and the game will start taking points away from you, forcing you to claw your way back up to regain your standing. Once a round ends, you gain a victory screen, and the race stops and restarts at the last position the victor was in. Then rinse and repeat until someone wins. It's a weird game, but not one that I've seen anyone make use of since. Though I could be wrong. The most obvious connection you can make to the game is Micro Machines, and that's fair, especially since Supersonic Software made a few Micro Machines games before Mashed. This stop and start structure might be a little off-putting to some, as it might make the game a little slower, but fuck me, is it fun. And tense. The way the scores work means you can be miles ahead and suddenly suffer a succession of losses that puts you miles back. But that isn't the end, as a player on one score can pull themselves back if they're creative enough, or at least get lucky. And the speed at which rounds end kind of reminds me of old samurai movies, where the whole focus is on tension that can be suddenly and violently ended with a single single note. Theoretically, this could mean that a game could last forever, but the game accounts for that by having its own sort of sudden death mode, where after a certain amount of time, the game stops taking points away from players each round if they lose. You have a pretty wide variety of weapons to use to get those points. There's machine guns, flamethrowers, guided missiles, mines, a shotgun, an oil slick, a flash bomb, a drum bomb, mortars, and the bane of my existence, the airstrike. These weapons vary in their usefulness, but the way you pick them up is pretty much exactly the same as Mario Kart. You drive through a box, and that weapon is instantly strapped to the top of your car. These weapons are color-coded, so you come to identify the useful ones pretty quickly, and by the end of the main game, you won't even have to think about which ones to grab. In order of usefulness, the guided missile is probably the most damaging, but not very reliable. Sometimes it'll send a car flying, sometimes it will lightly tap them. So it's better to use it on corners. To lock on, you drive behind the target long enough to get a lock. With AI, this isn't particularly hard, but in multiplayer with actual human reactions, you can make life a lot harder for someone with a missile by swerving around. The mortar comes next, which tends to do around the same sort of damage as a rocket launcher, except you have to aim it. You get 3 rounds per pickup, and the game has some not-so-subtle homing on them, so your shots tend to hit more than miss. Though if you get targeted by one, you can occasionally slam on the brakes and have the opponent run into their own mortars. The oil slick flamethrower and the flash bomb are what I would call disruption weapons. The flamethrower slows enemies down when they get caught in it, allowing you to pull ahead. The oil slick does what you'd imagine, lubing a track up and sending people skidding to their death, and the flash bomb whites out the screen for a few seconds. Against the AI, the flash bomb is actually quite useful, as the AI is programmed to slow down whenever you trigger it, but in multiplayer the flash period is extended, so you tend to just fuck yourself over as well as everyone else when you use it. Drum bombs send out 2 drum bombs, depending on the inertia of your turn, which can sometimes be dangerously unpredictable, especially since these things seem to have a huge area for splash damage. Shotguns are good for stopping people from overtaking you, and the mines do what you would expect. The real bullshit of the weapons comes down to the airstrike though, but we're not at that part yet. There are multiple game modes you can choose from if battle isn't your thing, but to be honest, I would say battle is the single reason for wanting to play this game. Throughout the main challenge cup, you'll come up against these game modes every now and then in between battles. Bomb trial is just time trial, except they strap a bomb to your car and each checkpoint you run through resets the bomb's timer by a few seconds. Race is just a traditional racing game with the same combat mechanics. Fugitive has you chasing down another player and the game ends once you touch them, and Kill the Copter is disappointing. I think it was designed to be some kind of boss fight, but it's not particularly challenging and is kind of janky, where you just dodge fire from the helicopter and return with your own until it goes down. Control-wise, I would say mashed is a little hard to get used to. Turning in this game is not like steering in a car. In a normal car, the more you turn the wheel, the more the car turns. Right? It goes in increments. In Mashed, there are only 2 options. No turn, and all of the turn. Imagine you're driving down a road, but anytime you want to turn, you're only allowed to slam the wheel to a full lock. That's Mashed. So, most of the time is spent compensating for your own turning. Add to that the varying levels of traction this game seems to have. Traction is a theoretical concept in Mashed, as if you don't learn how to control the handbrake, you will spend most of the game wondering why you keep sliding into the wall when you turn, when the turn you did wasn't even that intense or at speed. That's not even accounting for the fucking ice maps, where you have the same problem, except you control even more like a bar of soap someone punted into the bathtub. This can make ramming into opponents interesting, as you have to judge the length of the curve that the turn will put you in, so you can actually connect with the other curve. Unless you learn how to do the tail whip. Just tap the handbrake slightly and send people flying. It's amazing. While all of this is annoying, if you're planning to play this solo, there's another thing you have to watch out for, and that's the AI. The AI in this game is ruthless, and I'm fairly certain it cheats every now and then. Oh, it'll make you believe everything is fair once you start the game. But right around the midpoint, the AI decides to pull out the fucking knives and will not stop until it has personally identified your smoldering corpse in a morgue, sometimes to their own detriment. The suicidal AI will occasionally become so focused on ramming you off the map that they don't really care if they go down with you. Even on the all versus one maps, they will occasionally take out some of their own teammates just to ram your ass off the road. Strangely enough, the AI won't ram you unless you ram them, though. So it becomes this weird game of avoiding one another, because the minute you graze their car, the blood rage takes them over and you cast into Ram Ranch.
Eighteen naked cowboys in the showers at Ram Ranch. Big hard throbbing cocks wanting to be sucked. 18 naked cowboys wanting to be fucked.
The game has characters, in inverted commas, that you can choose. It literally just dictates what color your car is and the voice that the taunt button comes out with. Oh yeah, this game has an inbuilt taunt button, and it is every bit as annoying as it sounds.
Call it or lose it. Quit the jostling. Turkey. Ox brain loser.
I am living for pain. Foolishness.
Be gone.
I'm warning you.
Stock cop.
A little hoochie-coochie, huh?
This struggle arouses me.
It's fine if you're playing against friends where you have to actively press the taunt button to send out an insult, but if you leave taunts on and play an AI game, they will not shut up. It's cacophonous. They have callouts for everything. It's fucking constant and drives me insane. Thankfully, they give you the option to turn it off, because if they didn't, I would say this might make the campaign unplayable. At least with the sound turned on. In terms of presentation, MASHED isn't anything to shout about. It looks about how you'd expect a budget PS2 title to look, and as far as art direction is concerned, there isn't any. I will say the rain weather effects look nice, and it's pretty atmospheric. And the maps are at least interesting, though they do kind of bleed together. The map of Kings, though, is Polar Wharf. Honestly, I don't know why we spent so long playing this thing. It's literally just a circle circuit and that's it. But with the ice and the lack of sides to the road, it made ramming tense. As if you were good enough, sometimes it meant you could brake and send them diving off the stage. That and the end turn always causes people to oversteer, so everyone slams into the end like it's a fucking bumper car arena. As for other maps, the most interesting are probably aforementioned Polar Wharf, Demolish, and Ventura Boulevard, and probably Nukov, since it has this little floating platform which forces you into a ramming match that ends up looking like a shit episode of Robot Wars. Sufficient is what I would call MASH's presentation. There's nothing out of place bad, but it's not going to be blowing you away with its style anytime soon. The only thing I would say is a little odd is the music. MASH only has three music tracks. There's the one in the opening cutscene, the menu music, and the loading screen. Though, to be honest, the loading screen doesn't really count, since it's just the same hi-hat loop playing over and over again. Though, whether it's nostalgia or not, I really dig the other two tracks. I've used the menu music as backing for videos before, but I've never been able to find a clean version of the song in the intro cutscene without all the sound effects. They list the group's name in the credits, but a quick search doesn't turn up anything, so maybe someone watching this might have better luck. I don't know. But either way, MASHED isn't about the single player. This game is multiplayer first, and it shows. From the irritating AI to the repetitive maps, and the fact that there is really only one good game mode. Sure, time trials are fun for a bit, but the meat of the game is getting some friends together and joining the clusterfuck. If you want to play this single player, I can't really recommend it for you. Especially since multiplayer adds a whole new dynamic to a lot of what made the game irritating. The bullshit the AI would pull with ramming and weapons is no longer a problem, because you have the randomness of human input to worry about. It used to be every man for himself, but with multiplayer, occasionally you'll form mini mutual alliances to take down the player in the lead, since fighting among yourselves might give them the win. And the fucking airstrike politics that this game invents are amazing. In the main game, the airstrike isn't present, but in multiplayer, when you die, the game gives you the option to launch a missile at any player on the screen. So then suddenly you have players trying to negotiate with you as to why you should aim for the other player and not them. You have to take into account who is ahead and who is likely to pull forward in the next round. Or you could just fire at random and laugh at the chaos that causes. Honestly, I think the G20 summit should have a game of MASH set up in the corner at all times. Political rivalry goes out the fucking window when you're one stock away from winning and Angela Merkel is up your ass with the airstrike. That, and you can apply any of the customizations that the game's arcade mode gives you to the multiplayer. So if you want to have the Genesis Evo cars with no traction and chaos pickups on Polar Wharf, you can. The game even includes a share controller function that, to be honest, I had completely forgotten about. It basically means that if you don't have enough controllers, one player can control one side of the controller and the other on the other. Which sounds like it would be a complete shit show, but fucking have it anyway. In short, MASHED is a game that I have a weird love for that I can't really explain. But there's something to the main battle mechanic that just holds up for me. It's such a simple concept that has so many possibilities to how a game will turn out. Would I recommend MASHED? Sure. I think it's the perfect party game that went unseen, especially since Supersonic Software made a follow-up called Wrecked Revenge Revisited, which on top of being a shit name was a bag of wank. By the looks of things, Supersonic Software now only makes interactive board games and crosswords, which is kind of sad really. I guess there's just something to the main battle mechanic, and I just wish I could see more of it.